हेलो एवरीवन, इस वीडियो के अंदर हम सीखेंगे कि माइक्रोसॉफ्ट के अंदर हम फॉर्म्स कैसे बनाते हैं और उसके थ्रू हम असेसमेंट कैसे कर सकते हैं। तो सबसे पहले हमें सीखना होगा कि हमें ऑफिस का जो फॉर्म्स है वो कैसे खोलना है। तो इस वीडियो में हमें फॉर्म्स खोलने के लिए सबसे पहले ब्राउजर विंडो के अंदर office.com खोलना पड़ेगा। जैसे कि मेरी विंडो ऑलरेडी खुली हुई है, तो दिस इज द office.com वेबसाइट वेयर इन सो मेनी ऑप्शंस आर अवेलेबल हियर। सो मुझे अभी क्या बनाना है, मुझे इसमें एक फॉर्म बनाना है। तो सबसे पहले मैं फॉर्म्स खोलूंगा। फॉर्म्स के अंदर जाने के बाद अब मुझे एक जनरल इंफॉर्मेशन कलेक्शन फॉर्म नहीं बनाना, मुझे एक असेसमेंट फॉर्म बनाना है। तो सबसे पहले मैं इसमें क्या खोलूंगा, न्यू क्विज खोलूंगा। न्यू क्विज में इट विल आस्क मी फर्स्ट टाइटल ऑफ दिस फॉर्म। सो लेट्स से आई एम मेकिंग अ पेपर फॉर कंप्यूटर साइंस, सो आई विल राइट हियर कंप्यूटर साइंस, व्हाटएवर द सब्जेक्ट नेम। हियर इन आई कैन टाइप द क्लास name and it's this is a title, so I can write anything in the title of this file. Then I'll say add new. So these are the four types of question which I can type: choice, text, rating, date, and there are certain other things which need to be added, like file upload, like if somebody wants to give some attitude of this option, and net promoter score, somebody wants to give a score. So what we will use these two options, either choice or text. Will not use any of these option, ranking and all. So because we are making an MCQ type paper, so we'll use here MCQ. Like before starting the MCQ paper, we need to ask certain details to the student. So first I'll take text box wherein student will type the name of the student. There is no point, I'll mark zero, and I'll say required length, yes. Then there is no need to ask for the class, because the test will be belonging to a particular class called class 6. So there is no need to ask the class, only section is required. So I'll make a section, because I don't want a section should be option. So I'll add a new field called choice. I'll write here section and I'll add the option A, B, C, D, E. Let's say these are the options, and I said required because section needs to be required. Section डालना जरूरी है, but I want this should be a drop down. Drop down means it will not look like drop down. When I see the preview, it look like this kind of thing. So this is the option wherein I got a drop down list. Again, I'll go back because I need more questions here. So I'll add F and then add new. Add new means I need a email ID of the student as well, because that is required. So I'll add email ID. So these are my three basic option which I'm asking student while fill this form, while entering the data to the quiz. Now from here I'll start my questions. I want a MCQ questions, so I'll say write the full form of DBMS. Write the full form of DBMS. So that is my DBMS. So first option is data manipulation language. So I just make correction to this manipulation language. Data management system. Then I'll add more options. Data merge system, and this is my right answer, that is database management system is my right answer. So I'll say click and I'll give a marks, let's say 2. I'll add another question. I'll say again choice. Computer is an electronic device. I'll say true. False. So my right answer is true. I'll add one more question, again choice based. Speaker is input device. False statements, I'll say mark this. Then again another question, let's say Python language is an object-oriented programming language. Again, true or false. So I say true, then I say false. So my true is the answer. So again, true my question. Now I'll add another question. Again, let's say I say define computer. So I'll add define computer and I'll write add the answer here. It is an electron. It is an electronic device used for input the data and after processing output the data. So student will type this question. Again, let's say I can increase the marks. Let's say this is a 3 marks question. So I'll add the 3 marks. So this is my form is ready. I am having 8 questions in this. So I can see the preview wherein it will display the preview of this questions. Now I am ready with my paper. Now I need to do certain settings. Now how to do the certain settings and what are the things which we have to keep in mind? So I'll how to share. First question is how to share this form with the students. So I'll go to share. The first option is only in my organization can respond. This is a link which we need to copy and give to the student. This is the link which we need to give to the student. So I'll copy and I'll paste somewhere in my notepad file. So this is my link wherein which I have to give to my student. Yani ki ye wala link mujhe apne students ko dena hai. Then we'll go down. We have another link called get link to view the edit. Means there is another link which allow me to be owner of this form. It means if I get this link, I can change the form at my convenience, at my requirement, so that I can change. So I can copy. This is the link. So there are two links. Both look like the same, but the first one there is a student link which I need to give to the student. And the second one is a collaborative link which makes me owner of this form so that I can do the changes. So these are the two links which we need to provide to the student. The first link is to be provided to the student and the second link will be for the teacher or owner. Now what else setting we have to do? So I'll go to settings. Again I'm just clicking on the 3 dots. I'll go to settings. Show results automatically. I'll say no because I don't want the immediately once the student complete the task and that result will be available. I say no. Anyone with the link can respond? No. Only people in my organization can respond? Yes. Record name? Yes. One person per name? Yes. Accept responses? Yes. Start date. So herein I'll start the date. I'll say 15th and the timing is, let's say I want to start at 9 a.m. So I'll make sure that timing is 9 a.m. Then I can set the end date. Normally it takes a 1 hour window. So, but I can start at 9:30 and end up at 10. So it will work for 30 minutes. Now shuffle question. Now shuffle question is an option which will be only available when we have a single form. If you make a section wise, then it will not work. So log questions. So I'll say log the question 1 to 4 or 1 to 3. So that the 1 to 3 question remains same. And whenever somebody open this link, the question will get shuffled automatically so that baki bachcho ko same questions na mile. Then this is the log questions. I just log the 3 questions. Then I say customize thank you message. So I can write here something. Thank you for attempting this quiz. And I can write my name, Naveen Gupta, or something, whatever you want to write. So this message, whenever somebody fills the form, this message will be given to the student. and this all will be sent email to the recipient, whatever the email is filling. So automatically that link, that form with the complete data will be sent to the students. So this, my form is ready now. So I can share with the first link to the student, so that student can attempt this question paper or whatever we are saying assessment. Now how to see the result? Preview, I am already in the preview mode. So let's see the how it look like. Let's say I'm submitting the one result. I say Naveen Gupta, my name. Then I'll say section. Let's say I'm from the A section. I'm writing my email ID, whatever. It should be stmarkschool.in ID. Preferably, otherwise student can fill any ID. Let's say this is my ID. The first is DBMS, Database Management System. Second is true. Define computer. If you see, I have made this question define computer at the level say 8, but now it is displaying on the level 6. So automatically the shuffling of question happened and the three questions are fixed. So this is the way we can look forward to it. So I hope this video clears my all these doubts, and after seeing this video you will be able to create a form. Now responses, I can check the responses because I have not submitted, so it will not show me them. Let me fill up the one form responses, and then I can post the score. So when I click on the post the score option, it will send automatically. Let's say I'll just fill one form quickly. I'll just go to preview. I'll just fill submitted the section A, email ID, send an email, so submit. So once I submit, this form is not yet started because I have closed the window for the time. Let's do the changes. I'll make the changes to the form. I'll go back. Let's say today is 13, so I'll go to 13, and time is 8:30, so I'll start at 8:39. So it will be 28:30, and it will end up at 21. So this is my window. I say this. All this happen on the real time. So be careful. Whatever the changes you are doing, student can see immediately. So all these forms are real time. So whenever I am doing the changes, even if the student is filling up the form and you are doing some changes, so it will be working. It will display the changes to the student immediately. So be careful while changing and while creating this. So this all I have answered. Device again, you will see now it's 8th question. So I say submit. So thank you for attempting the quiz. So I have already implemented. So I'll go back, I'll see the responses. You will see average score is 4 because I have marked some enter wrong. And I can post the scores after completing the section, complete section. I can post the score. So I'll click on the post, it will open a window. Automatically, because only one record, it will automatically, I want to preview. I can see the preview of the student, what he has marked. So you can see it's showing me the preview of the window, whatever I have marked. So I'll go back, I want to send the mail. I say post score. If I click on the post score, automatically whatever the mail ID I filled, I have logged in, it will be displayed on my that window. So I'll go back to Outlook. I can see whether this is visible or not. So this is my response which I have filled. So my response, computer science ka paper maine fill kiya tha. So this is my response, and score is still working. So it will be posted in a minute. I have already posted, so it will be available here. Like view my responses. So whatever I have entered, I can see my responses, and later on the student can see the result here automatically in the mail account. I hope you have understood this concept, and you will be able to do the needful, and you will be able to create the form. Thank you so much. Thank you for your patience and thank you for listening to me. Thank you so much.